Hey and welcome to Ahrefs Monthly Product Updates. Today, we have three tool updates and one general update to share with you. Let's start with Site Explorer. Overview 2.0 is now the default report in Site Explorer. So, searching in the target search bar and clicking on Dashboard Project Cards will now lead you to Overview 2.0. We've also added a new year-over-year mode in Overview 2.0's history chart. This mode shows yearly growth and makes seasonal trends easy to see. For example, here I'm analyzing USPS's letters from sender page. If I select monthly volume, it incorporates trend data into the traffic estimates. We can see a big seasonal spike in traffic here, which corresponds with Christmas Day. Moving on, we've added a new report that many of you have been asking for. This is the new calendar report for positions, which shows you all position changes each day in a calendar format. For example, for ahrefs.com on the 3rd of July, you see that we had almost 8.7k new or improved positions, and around 2k lost or declined positions. Below, you see a breakdown of these movements. You can also click and drag on the calendar itself to select several dates at once. Positions is the first calendar report, and we're working to add calendar views for new and lost organic pages, referring domains, and backlinks. The calendar report is available on standard plans for new users and on advanced plans for legacy users. On to the final Site Explorer release this month. We've created two modes for keyword filters, phrase match and partial match. Phrase match is the default search mode and shows you results for full words and phrases. While on the other hand, partial match shows you results for partially matching phrases. For example, let's say that I want to filter for results containing the phrase market on our blog. I'd run a search with phrase match. This screens out results for phrases that aren't an exact match, like marketing. And if I use the partial match mode instead, this shows us results for partially matching phrases, like marketing. Let's move on to Keywords Explorer. We've added a couple of features that let you see historical SERP data. First up, in the SERP overview tables, you can select any date from this dropdown to see what the SERP looked like at that time. How far back you can view SERPs depends on your subscription plan. And second, we've added historical data to the positions history chart. Again, just choose a date and you'll see the top ranking pages on that day and their organic positions history for the target keyword. These features are useful for spotting changes in the SERPs. Take the keyword Corona for example. Prior to 2020, results were all about the beer. And now, results are split between the beer and the virus. Moving on to Site Audit. We've added a new Issues tab to the URL Details page that shows you all issues related to a specific page. So if you're fixing an error on a particular page, you can also look at all of the issues on that page and fix them all at once. Next up, our last general update. Search volumes are now available until May 2022. We've also added 345 million new keywords to our database, with over 200 million in the US alone. And that's it for our July updates. Let me know if you liked anything in particular this month, or if there's anything else you can do to make our tools better for you. And as always, subscribe to this channel for more product updates, tutorials, use cases, and me. See you in the next update. Bye!